Over the last couple of days, we've been looking at that opening statement in the Lord's Prayer, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. We saw that his personality is Father. His abode is in heaven. And this morning, we're looking at his character, which is holy. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. And the dictionary defines hallowed as sanctified, consecrated, highly venerated, or sacrosanct. In simple terms, we often use the word hallowed to refer to someone whom should be treated with awe and respect because they deserve it. And God, of course, deserves our awe and respect because he is worthy of it. Why does the Lord's Prayer say, hallowed be your name? You see, the phrase follows the opening of the prayer, which directly addresses God. So we should take from that not only is God hallowed or holy, but also his name should be hallowed. And to understand this, we first need to understand that the Jews had different naming customs than we have in the West today. To a Jew, a person's name was more rather than just a way to identify the individual physically. Their names also reflected something of their character. Jews named their children in a way that expressed the child's mission in life. And because of this custom, the Jewish people had about 16 different names for God in the Old Testament. And each name reflected a different aspect of God's character. So God's name were considered by the Jews to be just as holy as God himself. So our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. That states to us that not only is God holy, but his name is also holy as well. And we therefore should revere his name and never take his name in vain. When we pray the Lion, we recognize that he is holy. And in other words, he is God and I am not. God is holy in two particular ways. First, he is holy because he is free from sin. And secondly, he is holy because of his apartness, that is, his separation from the creature, from the created reality. God is creator. Everything else is created. God is separated. God is apart from that which he has created. So God's holiness is all that by which he is distinguished and distinct from us, his creation. Therefore, God is in heaven. He is apart from sin, apart from us, his created, and free from sin. And therefore, that poses the question this morning, if God is Father and invites me to have a relationship with him, if God is in heaven, his abode, and desires that I spend eternity with him in heaven, and God is also holy, how therefore is this possible? Because I know that I am a vile, wretched sinner. I have no hope in and of myself to stand before God in his blazing holiness. I am doomed in one sense. The words of Thomas Pynchon spring to mind. He too saw himself as a vile, wretched sinner when contemplating the blazing holiness of God. And then into his study came that shaft of light, of hope, that is found in the gospel. And so he penned the words. Oh, he said, how shall I, whose native sphere is dark, whose mind is dim before the ineffable appear, and on my naked spirit bear the uncreated beam. In other words, as I stand before God's blazing holiness, I'm lost, I'm doomed, I've had it. But then came that shaft of light, and he said, there is a way for man to rise to that sublime abode. An offering and a sacrifice, a Holy Spirit energizes an advocate with God. That is, he saw something of the glory of the cross. And Jesus came from heaven to earth, from the earth to the cross, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, in order that he might transport me. By me placing my faith and trust in his finished work on the cross, into the blazing holiness of God's presence in heaven to have eternal fellowship with God, my Father. So thank God this morning for the hope of the glorious gospel. And so I can pray this morning, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. God bless you. Pobendev.